This short animated video explains the concept of confidence interval and how to construct a 95% and 99% confidence interval with the help of some examples. So don't go anywhere else, just sit back, relax and enjoy this video. So before we understand what is confidence interval, let us first understand what do you mean by estimate. Everyone makes some kind of estimate at some point of time. Suppose you are crossing a road. You estimate the speed of a car that is approaching you. So based on this estimate, you decide whether to wait, walk or run. And everyone is making estimate. Managers, statisticians, they make a lot of estimate about the population. Let us look at the definition of estimate in the statistical term. Estimate is a specific observed value or a numerical value, I would say, which is used to estimate an unknown population parameter. It gives you some facts about how the population could be. We can have two different types of estimate: point estimate and interval estimate. Let us first look at the point estimate. So point estimate is a single value or a number that is used to estimate a population parameter. Let's take an example here. Let's assume that this is our population and we draw a sample out of it using any sampling technique. So we pick 4 people from this lot and we take an average weight of these 4 samples, which is coming around as 60 kg. So this 60 kg, which is the sample mean, is a single point estimate of a population mean. Point estimate is often insufficient because it is either wrong or right. Assuming that we know that we are wrong here and assuming that we are off target by 5 kg. So that means whatever we have expected 60 kg as an estimate is a good estimate here. But if you are off target by 20 or 30 kg, then that is not the right estimate. Also, this point estimate is going to be different from population parameter due to some sampling error. And there is no way we can know how close we are to the actual parameter. For this reason, statisticians prefer interval estimate, which gives them some range of values to estimate the parameter. That is why when we say point estimate, so sample mean is a point estimate of the population mean. Now let us understand the interval estimate. So interval estimate is a range of values which is used to estimate an unknown population parameter. It gives you the estimate that what is the range of values by calculating 2 numbers and interval but within which the parameter is expected to lie. Interval estimates of a population parameter are called confidence interval. And statisticians prefer interval estimate because interval estimates are accompanied by the statement concerning the degree of confidence. That is, the interval contains the population parameter being estimated. Confidence interval, which is the most common type of interval estimate, is made up of 2 elements. One is your point estimate and another is your margin of error. As it is written as point estimate plus minus your margin of error. So it indicates an error in 2 ways. One by the extent of its range and other by the probability of the true population parameter that is lying within this range. So this is how we define the point estimate and the width of confidence interval. Confidence interval are often confusing. When we construct a confidence interval, we are estimating a population parameter based on the data that we have collected from a sample. So 95% confidence interval is a range of values that can be 95% certain or confident will contain the true mean of a population. So the correct representation of 95% confidence interval is that we are 95% confident that the population mean mu would lie between 50 and 70. Now let us understand this with the help of some examples. So first example that we have taken, where we are constructing a confidence interval for a single population mean So this is our problem statement, where we have a random sample of n equal to 50 males, which shows an average mean daily intake of dairy products equal to 756 grams with a standard deviation of 35 grams. So we need to find the 95% and 99% confidence interval for the population average. This is the formula that we have. We are going to use in this case. So we have given the sample mean as 756 grams, n equal to 50, standard deviation as 35, and for 95% confidence, z value is 1.96 that we can get it from z table. So let's put all these in the table for interval estimate. 756 plus minus 1.96 into 35 divided by 50. So we get, this is the range that we are getting for 95% confidence interval. Now for 99%, our z value is 2.576. Now we replace this z value with this and we get a different confidence interval. So now that our new confidence interval for 99 is this one, 743 plus 0.2 and 768.766 grams for 99% confidence interval. Now let's take a different case study where we are constructing a confidence interval for a single population proportion. So this is our problem statement, a billing statement for 1,000 patients discharged from a particular hospital were randomly selected for error. And out of these 1,000 billing statements, 102 were found to contain error. So we are using this formulation to construct a 99% confidence interval. So we are going to use this formula for population proportion, where p hat stands for x bar divided by n, where p is a random and varies from sample to sample, where n here is the sample size and x is the observed number of success in the sample. Let's put all this in the formula. So we have p hat as 102, that is a total error that we have, divided by total number of patients. So we get 0.102. N is 1000 here, so we'll put in this in the formula, we'll get this value. So this is our, and from z table, like for 99% confidence we get 2.576. Now we'll put all this and we get an interval range as 0.077 to 0.127 for 99% confidence interval. So in short, we are saying that we are 99% confident that the true proportion of billing statement that contains error would lie between 7.7% and 12.7%. So that is all I have on this video. If you like it, click here to subscribe. Do hit the like button as well and share this video with all your friends on different social media platforms. And if you have any specific comments or suggestions, you can leave your suggestions in the comment section below.